Ah, there you are. Did you enjoy your nap? We don't have much time before we reach the station at Saint-Geneviève. You don't remember? Sleep-induced amnesia? How odd. Well, try to gather your wits. I need your help. I am Joseph Rouletabille, investigative reporter for the Epoque. You are Sinclair, my photographer. We are traveling to the Chateau de Glandier to investigate the murder of Mademoiselle Stangerson. I see you have not located your camera. What good is a photographer without his camera? You must search the luggage car. Now go, we haven't much time. Hurry! What are you doing? You'll need to be a bit more sly if you want to help me on this investigation. I am listening to the magistrate de Marquet and his deputy. They're talking about the murder.
How can this be? The yellow room was locked, dead bolted from the inside, firm iron bars on the only window, solid brick walls, but how did the murderer escape?
Yes, a strange and stupefying mystery indeed. We may never know the answer.
I hope it is never solved. I love the countryside, Deputy Dupier. This is the life. To breathe the fresh air every day. I'm tired of the city.
But Magistrate, it is our duty to solve the case.
Oui, oui, but if the case isn't solvable, then we shall have to stay in the village of Saint-Geneviève for a long time. That is my hope. That is my hope.
The train is pulling into the station. We must move quickly so the magistrate doesn't catch on that we were listening to his conversation. The magistrate left without us. We must find our own way to the chateau. Look for a means of transportation. The chateau is too far away to walk. ¶¶
Thank you. Thank you.
I found a car for us to use, but it is in disrepair. Can you help me fix it? Thank you, St. Clair. You may prove useful after all.
See, you have gained admittance to the grounds, huh? But you needn't bother. I, the great detective Fred Larson, have already solved the case. I will reveal my findings at the Yellow Room in 2 hours' time. Give up, Rouletabille. You are too late.
Thank you.
stop! You may not be admitted to the gate without authorization, under orders from Magistrate de Marquet and Detective Fred Larson. Stop! You may not be admitted.
Thank you. Oh, I didn't know more visitors would be coming. I am Madame Matthew, the innkeeper's wife. I'm sorry, but all the rooms in the inn are occupied with the detective staff. I was, tending to poor Mathilde Strangerson. Many think she was killed by the attack, and she might as well have been. She is very shaken up indeed. But come, come inside. My husband, he is serving as the concierge.
Full up. There will be no snooping around in here. If you find out what time my shipment train is expected, I might reconsider. The train is supposed to be coming from Calais. Bleu, they are late again. I cannot deal with photographers now. Please go.
Blah. This tea is so bitter. Surely some honey will do.
Thank you.
sweetness of honey. You may look around, I suppose.
Yes, I've read your articles, Mr. Rouletabille, but I cannot allow any reporter on the chateau premises. I, myself, am a guest of the Stangersons.
The presbytery has lost nothing of its charm, nor the garden its brightness.
How could you... Where did you hear that phrase?
I will reveal my sources, Mr. Darzac, if you help us gain admittance to the chateau.
Oui, oui, of course. Let us go, monsieur.
Thank you.
Oh, that flash is blinding. What are you doing here? Who are you? Excuse my manners. I guess I was just taken aback. My name is Daddy Jacques, a good friend and assistant to Professor Stangerson. Ah, poor Mathilde. The nurses are tending to her inside. My poor, poor Mathilde. She's not accepting visitors at this time.
What are you gawking at? These are the caretakers. They've been arrested for suspicious behavior. They were fully dressed at the crime scene just moments after the crime. Who gets dressed so quickly in the middle of the night? They must have been already awake about some mischief.
They were not involved with the crime, you know, but I do believe they are guilty of something. Just as a magician cannot reveal his trick, I cannot say, but I do know it for certain.
Thank you.
This is it, the crime scene. Very curious indeed. How did the assassin escape? I must get a closer look. Make yourself useful, St. Clair.
Thank you.
There you are, St. Clair. Everyone is gathering outside to hear Fred Larson's theory. Come with me.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm sure it is with much disdain that we gather here together in the presence of the great detective Fred Larson. He will present his leading theory, which I will deem correct or not. And I hope that it is not.
Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the accomplice of the killer, Mr. Stangerson. How could you let such an atrocity happen to your own daughter? There was only one moment when the attacker could have escaped, right through the only door of the Yellow Room. With the help of Monsieur Stangerson, of course. You see, when Monsieur Stangerson and Daddy Jacques tried to break down the door, Daddy Jacques left for a moment to get the caretakers. That is when Monsieur Stangerson opened the door and let the murderer escape.
But are you mad? My own daughter? This is the most preposterous thing I've ever heard!
Oh, I'm sorry, but this just will not do. I do not believe Monsieur Stangerson is involved with the crime whatsoever. There must be another solution.
Monsieur Larson has given much away. Monsieur Darzac, you must listen to me. Detective Larson will stop at nothing to prove that you are the attacker. All of the evidence points to you, but I know that you are innocent.
Thank you, Rouletabille. I want you to know I expect the assassin again this evening.
Thank you.
Sinclair, there you are. The assassin is expected to return this evening, but we have a dinner appointment with Fred Larson. We must find a place to hide after dinner so we can catch the killer.
Second, he has not been shot. He was stabbed to death.
What is going on? Is it morning already? Oh, where am I? Sinclair, did the assassin come while I was asleep? Ah, tragedy. I'll go investigate. You must go and find Fred Larson and see if he's okay.
Okay.
Sinclair, meet me by the train station at once. I must speak to you. I have not been completely open with you, Sinclair. I must explain to you how I know of Robert Darzac's innocence. You see, the night before the attack at the Yellow Room, there was a convention of scientists in France. I attended, by duty of the epoch, to write the story. Then I happened upon a very dismal couple in the bushes. It was Mathilde and Darzac. They were reading a letter from an anonymous source that said, "The presbytery has lost nothing of its charm, nor the garden its brightness." Well, as I sat behind them, I heard Darzac whisper dismally to Mathilde, "Shall I commit a crime for you, my dear?" The letter was a coded threat. Someone from the secrets of Mathilde's past, and Robert Darzac was willing to take the fall if it would set her free from this threat. I must travel to America. Something tells me that this presbytery is there somewhere. I'll be back in 3 weeks' time. Take pictures of anything peculiar you find.